I'm Gail C, Director of Teaching and Learning here, and this week I have Joellen Killion with me. And Joellen has come to us from the United States. She's coming with a wonderful array of background knowledge and her experience. She's the Senior Advisor to the Learning Forward organization in the United States, which really is the organization for professional learning, professional development in the US. So we're very lucky to have coaxed her here to be with us, and we've been looking at two different aspects which Joellen holds in her bag of tricks. So first of all, she worked with our curriculum team and our tech integrators around coaching and trying to move from a consultative model in their role to a coaching model. Joellen, do you want to talk to us about what we did and what you saw?
Well, thanks. Let me just first start by saying thank you and how delightful it is to be back.
Oh, yeah, we're glad to be back.
After so many years. And yes. When we think about moving from that consultative to a coaching role, really what we're talking about is how do we help people who are in roles designed to support the effective teaching and learning move from being so directive in their work to really tapping into the skills, the strategies, the thoughtful processing that educators use, and helping them be more conscious of that, more successful with their work, and being more deliberate in their work.
Right, and then but not coaching from a deficit model, but coaching from a strengthening and a long partnership parallel with the work.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We hold a really strong belief that everyone coaches everyone else. When students learn to coach each other by asking questions about what caused you to think that way?
Right.
What were you considering? What criteria? When teachers coach students in that way, helping students be more aware of their thought process, the decisions they're making, and how they're integrating what they're learning in order to get better. And that transcends to how the adults interact with each other. We want every educator, everyone in the school, to begin to ask those kinds of questions of one another,
right,
to help them become more aware and more effective.
Right, and we had a great meeting with that group to talk about what our next steps will be as we move along this continuum of coaching.
Yes.
So I thank you for that work.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Joellen's other expertise is in the community of practice work that we have been stepping into here at ASD and really trying to put together what our non-negotiables are as a school and how do we work together as a full community. Mm-hmm. Would you like to talk about that for us?
Well, communities of practice is a term that's been around really for almost 50 years. And what it means is that people recognize that coming together, being more deliberate and intentional in supporting the growth and learning of one another can strengthen the entire community. And in a school like ASD, there are multiple communities working. There's the entire school community, and it's supported by many smaller communities, and helping each of those communities understand what makes them a community, how they really can grow and learn to be better than they are, to learn and then be able to enact their learning for the benefit of each other and the entire school community. It's not a new concept, but being more aware of how to do that with intentionality can transcend to more effective practice and even greater student success.
So today we had the opportunity to sit in there as a leadership team and process and look at what are our big goals that we as a community are working towards. So I thank you again for that work with our leadership team, and I'm sure that we will continue to deepen our understanding and to narrow our focus around those big important goals as we look at moving towards our vision. So we thank you for being here again.
My pleasure. It's an honor.
Thank you. Thank you very much.